For this reason, they are planning a huge PKI. Each issuer operates a self-controlled certification authority. The signer keys are diverted from the CA root, and the public keys are distributed by an ICAO PKI distribution, so everyone can verify. Unfortunately, they have just forgotten to make a CIL. So if one country is losing the keys, the complete system is doomed. So let's come to a specific part of this presentation. We have spent some time to make it possible to clone these passports. So we have here some standard dual interface tags. They are using a JCOP. This is a Java card operating system. And with some additional programming and reading the standards, they could act as a machine-readable travel document. The data could be retrieved from an issued passport, and personalization is possible through a special shell at the backend to RF dump. And let's check how the cloned passports behave. For this reason, I got a small tool. It was developed by the German state, and it's called Golden Reader Tool. So let's start the Golden Reader. And I've brought, this is my own passport. Please excuse me, there is a rule. We have to look in a specific way on this passport because otherwise the biometric will not work. So I'm putting it on, telling them reading basic access control, pointing to my MRZ. I've just programmed it. There are two ways I can install a reader, like to swipe it through a keyboard here. It's supported, or I can just punch it in. Please place passport. And now it starts reading and getting all the information out of my actual passport. So now you can see it's checking the data groups. It's checking the SOD message digits, it's checking the certificate, it's checking the signature, and it's checking the hash. Certificate status and certificate revocation are not implemented, so it's not checked. COM integrity is checked, reading data group 1, reading data group 2, reading hashes, and that's it. Now let's come to the interesting facts. So we want to see something more than only this one. So I'm starting small tool. This is called a smart card shell. Okay, I got it. So with an R, I sent a reset. That's a smart card protocol. And I can start scripts to perform operations. So what this script is actually doing, it's making basic access control, accessing to the passport with the ICAO protocol, and just dumping the whole context of the smart card, just the four different files onto my hard drive. After they are dumped, I'm using one of these normal available smart cards. Cost 15 euros, about $20. You can buy it via the web at IBM Zurich. Put it onto the reader. Starting a personalization tool and just writing the data, including the ICAO layout, directly into the corresponding new chip. I need to remove it, so I need to reset the cards. This card has application loader, it has flash memory, it needs to boot, so I need to put it off, put it back, and now let's check our result with the Golden Reader once again. Oh, who is that? Okay. Am I so boring? Or was the party so huge? Hello, wake up. Okay. But I can do just more fancy stuff with this. I can just use someone else's data. Now, I will join a new country. All are so evil to me, so I'm going to join to Utopia. So I'm just copying someone else's data directly to the file, overwriting all files, making a reset to the card. Okay, here we are. And you can see it's a Jacob 4.1 version 2.2. And now I want to just try what's happened. So I'm taking this passport, I'm using a hammer, deconnecting or destroying the microchip, and putting a new one into the passport, like this type, and putting my new passport back onto the inspection system. And now what's happened? Oh, this is obviously not me. Okay. Let's go back to the presentation. So, we have some security issues. First of all, the UID from this tag could be changed from any tag. So with this type of tags, if we have an access control system and it's using only a unique identifier, this tag has a small algorithm generating a random number and sending it as unique identifier. So if you change it, you can fool out any ISO 14443 access control systems. They only rely on a unique identifier. The next thing is the passport tag could act as access control tag, and the biggest risk is that the manipulated data group, and if we have some more time, I would love to present you how it's able to change it. The manipulated data group could crash the reader and the terminal. Unfortunately, they made everything wrong that they could be. So they don't understand how ASN1 is working, so they tried to re-implement it. They make it not correct, so you cannot pass it against the normal ASN1 library because you have to do exceptions. They are breaking the standards. It's no longer possible to validate it against ASN1 lex, and so on. Each programmer has to reinvent the wheel and can trap to ASN1 parsing errors. You have problems with the data. You have problems with the data size. You have problems. The picture is encoded in four different encodings. We have an ASN1 encoding on top. Oh, I can demonstrate this. We have an ASN1 encoding on top of the ASN1 encoding. We have this biometric file format. Included in the biometric file format is a JPEG 2000 and the biometric template, and everything is encoded in a TLV encoding on the smart card. So in fact, this means how many mistakes could be done and how many ways to make a buffer overrun or to make an exploit to inspection system. And even if the cryptography is secure, and the cryptography is really secure, you can break through the system through an automated access control system into some country if you just break the access control system, put in an exploit, and what's doing? Oh, this exploit is only jumping to the part where the gates open. So we have a golden entrance for all automated inspection systems. Okay, let's shift to questions if you have any questions. Yes? Oh, I have one of this cage with me. But no one is brave enough to bring his passport to me. So if someone is interested, he can get his cages after the demonstration here. These are the specific things. And I'm just putting my one also back, just in case. Yes? No. Yeah? Okay. So the basic access control has nothing to do with the stored data on the RFID chip. The basic access control is used from the program loader to grant access to the machine, and I can just personalize any key, any desk key for basic access control. So it's possible to get someone else signed passport as a blob using something completely different for the basic access control and put it onto a RFID chip. So you can use your old passport to upgrade it with the old printed MRZ to a new passport with basic access control. And we can personalize it and we can just change the basic access control. It has nothing to do, and they are not checking the basic access control data and the key against the stored MRZ on the passport. They are two different things. Any more questions? Okay, thank you for your attention.